Ceci n'est pas un pipe, which means this is not a pipe. Are you confused too? Hi everybody, my name is Tina Prokhorova. I'm graphic designer and illustrator. Today I would like to tell you a little about illustration in general and about illustrative JetBrains system in particular. But first of all, let's go back to this mysterious pipe. René Magritte writes the signature, this is not a pipe. But he can't fool us. We can see, this is a pipe. No, Magritte repeats in his next work. And in it, he gives us a hint. After looking at it for a few seconds, we get an insight. Ah, of course, this is a portrait of a pipe. Is that so? It's much closer, but actually, in this case, these are just pixels and only three colors. Red, green and blue, because we are looking at the screen. So, what is this? Most accurate answer, though the most abstract, would be to say that this is an image of a pipe. This word is broader than the usual definition, and I would really like to use the word symbol. But symbols are just one of the categories of the images. So, symbols. Some of them represent concepts, ideas, and philosophies. There are symbols that people have agreed to use in science, literature, or to simplify written communication. And finally, there are symbols that have their analogs in the real, physical world. In other words, these symbols are more illustrative than others. The meaning of the symbols is fixed and absolute. Their style doesn't matter because they represent invisible ideas. But in illustration, the meaning depends on how different it is from real life, how abstract the image is. The maximum level of illustrative abstraction is text. Have you ever discussed a fiction book with your friend? If yes, then you can understand this. How you imagine landscapes and characters can be really different from someone else's vision. The level of abstraction is what in some cases can be called style. Before deciding on the style, you need to consider the context and be aware of where and what the images will be used for. A photo, for example, as close as possible to the original source. Of course, it's flat and we can't look at person from different angles and do not see the exact details of this person. But it conveys realism quite well and we can use it when it's necessary to project the image of this certain person. Further, we have realistic images. We often use them in cartoons, comics, some videos, etc. As the image becomes simpler, so does its function. It's important that in most primitive lines, we can still recognize the original source. And moreover, in three circles and just one line, we can recognize a person. What magic is this and how is it possible? There is an amazing person on the earth. His name is Scott McCloud. He is an American cartoonist and comic book theorist. He has spent a lot of time studying how the human brain perceives images and shared these knowledges with artists. He wrote several books. In one of them, he presents a very curious theory. Imagine that your face is a mask, looking outward. A mask that you wear from your birth and that fulfills any of your facial expressions. And everyone can see it except you. You can open and close your eyes, and mask will obey. You can smile. You can try it even right now while no one sees. What has changed? What have you seen? Most likely nothing. But at the same time, you know that you smiled because you felt your cheeks tighten and your eyes narrowed. So you know on the physical level that the mask, called the face, has obeyed. And in this moment, everyone sees your face, except yourself. In a lively dialogue, people perceive the partner and themselves differently. We can see another person in every detail, every eyelash, every wrinkle. But at the same moment, we represent ourselves in an abstract image, really abstract image, that we saw in the mirror. For example, right now, I don't see myself, but I can imagine myself very distantly because I have been living with this face for quite a long time. Well, I have brown eyes, oval face, bangs. In other words, I operate with very abstract images and imagine something cartoonish and really simple. Something like this. That is why you can only see another person in a photo or some realistic image. And in simple cartoon, you can see yourself. Of course, you may not, because everyone has very different perceptions. But in any case, the chances are really great, as large as possible. This theory is confirmed by examples of even ancient table paintings. People were portrayed in very abstract way. In the case of hunting, man's portrait resemblance is not needed. Only image of a man is important. But the beast was drawn in every detail, well, as far as possible that time. Men paid a lot of attention to the beast, so that everyone remembered exactly what it looked like to catch it. Which of these identical people will catch the beast is not so important, because in the evening, the whole community will share the meal anyway. Sometimes simplification in images plays a huge role. If the road signs, for example, depicted the silhouette of a real person, well, then there is a great chance that we would not be able to recognize it from afar and at high speed. Simplification concerns not only the face, but the whole body. After all, we don't have to see our hand to know that it's holding a cap, for example, right? These questions were studied by representatives of the Bauhaus. It was a German art school operational from 1919 to 1933 that combined crafts and the fine arts. How can you bend simple lines so that you can still guess human movements? Children's drawings are an interesting example of image simplification. If the mother wears large earrings, then the child doesn't care what kind of face the portrait turns out to be. The main thing is to draw large earrings, then it's mom. An interesting case was described in Victor Melamed's book. He is an artist and illustration teacher, but he is also the owner of the beard and glasses. One day he was walking with his child and met a couple of tourists along the way. The man they met also wears a beard and glasses. Then Victor's child became so confused in this established image that he cried, not knowing who exactly his daddy was. Simplification of images is also often used in theater. This is necessary so that viewer from the last rows can quickly understand what kind of character is in front of them. So, looking at the historical branch, we can see some trends in the visual arts. At first, the essence was the most important for the image. This is due to faith, religion, and ideas about life. People have been drawing within the framework of a simple style for decades, well, with different degrees of elaboration of details. Then the era of realism began, and then the return to imagery and simplicity began again. Why do you think there was a very sharp turn away from realism? Here in the center, you can see the work of Rembrandt as a representative of realism, and he is placed here not by mistake. His story is very revealing. In the 17th century, Netherlands was under the reign of Spain. All residents were equally poor and unhappy. At that time, people were themselves, didn't play any roles, were sincere and simple. Rembrandt portrayed the very essence of a person, and it was appreciated. Then the Dutch Revolution took place. Netherlands finally got free of Spain and got full independence. The life of the people became better, and the Baroque fashion came from France. Now everyone wanted to be captured on a portrait as a magnificent image, not as themselves beaten by life. Partly because of this historical context, poor Rembrandt, bathed in glory throughout his life, ended up in poverty. But let's go back to our diagram. We can depict a visual trend diagram like a roller coaster. Throughout history, artists either rise to detail and then return to very essence of things. Now is the borderline period. Many artists coming back to a simplified style. And there is one problem. Take a look at these pictures. There are several illustrations. They are all harmonious in colors and done very well. However, these are illustrations of completely different companies. But they look like they were drawn by the same person. And moreover, the last image was taken from the stock. So, what to do? How to stay in simple system but stand out and be memorable? How did the artist decide to solve this problem? They go back to detailing again, but a completely different one. They start experimenting with the essence, playing with the meanings. And this is not a trend of the last year, but it started recently. Remember that we're talking about global temporal context. Bauhaus artists, for example, experimented with geometric shapes so that human body was still guessed. Further, the era of experiments and cubism. This is Malevich, Picasso, and many others. Then we can see the results of experimental searches on the covers of printed publications, then into popular culture. And now everyone is beginning to experiment. Okay, but there is another question. How can we choose the image of a person for illustration if we are all so different? Not only in terms of personality, but in terms of appearance as well. Anthropologists count 36 human skin tones. Not bad. This is what we came up to in JetBrains. We started with the maximum simplification of the face, the purest symbol of a person. We even removed the mouth to make the face as abstract as possible. We left only the eyes as an accent. After all, honestly, what do you see here? And here? Most likely you see eyes here. Am I right? This is due to evolutionary settings in our brains. We have to identify two points as two eyes of the potential predator looking out of the bushes. Okay, talking about our character. In general, everything went perfectly, except one tiny thing. Our character turned out to be an absolutely insensitive person. He reacted with a poker face to all life situations. How to get out of this? We've come up with something. To begin with, I'll start with a list of random facts that will eventually merge. Fact number one. In the human brain, the centers responsible for speech and small movements are very close. All body movements and speech have the same mechanisms. Therefore, development of fine motor skills stimulates them very well. Fact number two. Nowadays, in the theatrical world, there are a lot of works about expressive gesticulation with methods of even antique orators. Fact number three. In the modern world, people often check their social networks from mobile devices that have pretty small screen diagonal. To see small details, we often have to enlarge the images. And this is tiresome action. But even sitting in a comfortable place in front of decent screen, it is easier for us to perceive concise, short, and large information. Often we even only read the headlines in the news list. You already understand what I'm getting at, right? We decided to focus on the hands. The characters' hands and gestures have gone through different stages and iterations. And finally, they have grown large enough to emphasize our illustrations and make them memorable. In this way, thanks to gestures, we were able to get feelings from our character. Now his hands speak, and sometimes even more vividly than his face would do. Now let's face it, our style is trending, but are we so unique now? You probably have already seen this style, am I right? It should be noted that the level of abstraction in these illustrations should not be called fashion. This is a logical conclusion that went through all the stages of roasting before getting on the table of consumers. But what makes us different from these illustrations? We have a system. Imagine a staff of 40 designers. The task is to draw the Mona Lisa. If you ask each of our designers to draw her, you get 40 completely different portraits. Moreover, the style of even one artist can easily change throughout life. A prime example are these self-portraits by Pablo Picasso. Have you ever thought that we still recognize the cartoons we grew up on and don't see any substitution? I ask because some artists who once invented them may already be dead. Sorry. It's all about the system. It is very long and painstaking work, but it is worth it. First of all, the artists think over the personality of the character and the structure of his body. Yes, it is a very interesting process, but it is also a great analytical work. But then, when all the elements of the character are ready and the huge mechanism of illustrative system begins to work, it looks like a miracle. Everyone can create a character from these elements, and it will live perfectly in the system. So we started from the very basics. All element widths are fixed. They are always 96 and 48 pixels. The length is variable, which helps to fit characters playfully in any format. Radiuses can be double scaled. The head is almost always in a certain distance from the body. Arms and feet are always scaled in proportion to the head. We also use only two types of the strokes, 1 and 8 pixels, with the rounded edge. After the work of the character's skeleton was completed, it was the turn of the limbs. We started, of course, with hands. Our task now is to think over the maximum number of gestures and positions of the hands. Even though the face remains the same, we can still add personality to the characters. For that, we started building a library of different hairstyles and heads. Besides interesting elements, you need to think about boring ones too. This is behavior of the body, the bends of the arms and legs. At the beginning, for example, we had strict rule about angles. We only used 45 degrees. Now, the system gets more complicated, and we added an angle of 22 degrees. Colors in our system are always fixed. Here you can see the JetBrains color palette. We always use a grid and some rules according to it. Thanks to this approach, we can use illustrations in different planes and scales. Personally, I use the same way in street art. So the grid can be found not only in digital world, but in real life as well, especially in architecture. Now let's see what scale the illustration can reach. So, if we take a closer look at this image, we can see the system grid, which is based on architectural details. A system like this helps us easily play with the dimensions of the illustration. So we can use the smallest model for the small sizes, user picks, for example, or make images huge, and they will interact with the space very well. Gradually, we learned how to use our system and decided to complicate it. Now the characters are acquiring personality. They choose clothes to match their character. We are developing this system so that all the designers of the company can use it. But why only designers, we thought? And so the Rendler was born. After this talk, I would like to invite you to a workshop where we will tell you how to use it. Thank you for your attention and see you soon.